Well, it took quite a while, but I have resurrected the turntable that we pulled out of the stereo, and it's been sitting in the basement for however long it's been. So what I started to do was, first thing I did is I built this little platform so, you know, the unit would sit down. I've got a little bit of suspension built into it using the springs that Dad had hooked up to it. The turntable itself looks really good. You know, it was nothing but, it was just dirty is all it was. So, you know, I just cleaned it up a little bit. There was a dust bug mount sitting here for years that was impossible to get off. I mean, this thing, I don't know if it was glued on or what. I ended up having to actually get it off with a razor blade, and it left horrible residue here that was really tricky to try to remove without scratching the paint on here. And after a lot of experimentation with different solvents that you think would have taken care of it, what I actually ended up using was this Permatex hand cleaner. I just dabbed this on there and let it sit for about 15 minutes, and it turned all that gunk that was there and real hard glue and rubber or whatever else was there. It actually softened it so I could actually scrape it off with my fingernail. So it cleaned up really nice. And once I had it all hooked up, you know, I was able to try it. You can see it runs fine at 33. The sure tone arm was, you know, the tone arm was fine. But what I found out is that the needle on the cartridge was shot. So I actually was able to find a new one without too much difficulty. So I just got that on there last night. The other thing I thought was interesting is, you know, I never really understood what this mechanism was before. And I finally realized how it works. I mean, it's a cueing mechanism. You know, the idea is it's actually kind of a gas-filled thing. So you lift it up, you can let go, and it drops slowly. So if you know, kind of move this out towards the record, and if you have it properly adjusted, you know, it will safely drop on there without having the needle skip across the record. So it's kind of neat to finally figured out how that works. So it actually is all set up. I found I actually had my old Sony receiver. Still seems to be totally operational. I have a couple of old Bose inner audio speakers that are still fully functional. So I'm actually in a position here where I can listen to my records in at pretty good quality. So I'm pretty happy with that.